Adios, Drew. See how it is. Hey, rednecks. Hello, redneck here. I'm back with another weird errands. This one's gonna be shorter. You guys said, or just one guy. My girlfriend said she liked the shorter ones. So here's the shorter one. Too bad the next episode is gonna be insanely long because tomorrow I'm going to a camera store that is far away. And you'll see that episode eventually. But anyways, today I'm going to the Beasleys and I want to talk about I want to talk about what we do. So every Friday I take this journey through these stupid roads. I'm so sick and tired of these stupid roads, but I take this journey, all right, through the wilderness to go to the Beasleys. They live on the littest cul-de-sac ever. Seriously, just, they've got all the people and this car feels weird. It's like 30 nothing degrees outside. It's cold. So I don't know what we're gonna do, but we usually end up bouncing through the woods, doing just whatever we want, really. Tucker got this crazy electric, like, plastic gun thing, but it shoots Orbeez. It's like a Nerf gun, but it's better. So I'm gonna ouch! I'm gonna experience that in its full glory. And I'm also gonna experience the chaos that is the intersection of Old Griffin and Tabor. But I have a whole bunch of news for the 10 people who watch this. This series is actually getting more views than a normal video would, which is cool. But anyways, that's beside the point. I got a film camera and two more lenses for $125 for some stranger behind Quick Trip. No, it's a racetrack. Yeah, it was a racetrack. It was awesome, and I was gonna go meet up with this guy because he talked to me on Facebook and he's like, "Hey, I have a film camera. I see you're looking for a film camera. I have a film camera if you want it." And then we were just talking. He wanted $125 for the camera, which is a Canon Rebel G. It's nothing super crazy. Actually, it's nothing crazy, like, at all. It's a pretty basic camera, but I like it. It's what I need. $125 for the Rebel G, the kit lens it comes with. I forgot what, I think it's a 35 to 80. Yeah, 35 to 80 kit lens. And a 100-300 Sigma zoom lens with the really noisy autofocus motor. And a big bag to put everything in, and it still had the manual. It is crazy, and I shot a roll of film two nights ago, I think it was two nights ago. And that was a whole red light that they just ran. Two nights ago, I shot a roll of film at night. It came with two rolls of film, which was pretty awesome, considering how freaking expensive film is. I shot them at night because that's the only time when I'm not busy, and it was the film I shot. It was Kodak 800, old film stock from a million years ago, because it came in little black cylinders as opposed to little clear cylinders. It came in little black cylinders, some discontinued stuff, broski. And it's probably nothing special, but it's 800 speed, and I think that works at night. I don't really know enough about film yet to know if that works, but we're about to figure out as I am going to that camera store to develop it. I'm gonna get it developed. I was emailing them about mailing my film in because I don't want to go all the way to Atlanta. I don't want to go all the way to Atlanta to get this film done. So I emailed them about mailing it in, and they never responded, and I was about to call them, but they have the dumbest hours ever. By the time I get home from school, they've been closed for 2 hours. It's crazy. Tomorrow their hours are 10 in the morning to 2 in the afternoon. It's just like the weirdest thing. So I bought into this whole film thing because the film looks awesome. It's a great way to hone in my actual photography skills, and it puts more purpose into my photographs, considering they're about like 50 cents a shot. They're expensive, and I've got to go through the hassle of developing them. So it gives my pictures some worth that I didn't have before, because I found myself just spamming the shutter button on my digital SLR, which is a Canon SL2 for those of you wondering. Just spamming the shutter button on that, taking a whole bunch of pictures, which it kind of worked because it let me take some really, really cool pictures. Like, some of them just hit different. But this one, hopefully I'll shoot just as cool pictures, but I'll put more meaning behind them. Like, it's more of a deliberate thing. I don't know, I think about it more. It's more analog. It doesn't kind of act up on me like my camera. I don't know, there's something to it. I like it. And the night before last, I went out with a tripod and I took some long exposure photographs of my neighborhood. Maybe they'll be good. We'll see. I don't know how long it takes film to get developed. This camera store is probably pretty busy, considering they're the only freaking camera store in Atlanta that develops film, I think. Don't quote me on that. There might be another one in Buckhead that I'm not aware of that I'm also gonna go to. But yeah, that's that. That's the story. That's the deal. But the one scary thing about film is you don't know if your shot's good till you get it developed. And since these are my very first film shots, I have no idea what I'm doing. So I have no idea what I'm doing, and I can't see if it's good. So I don't know if it's working until I'm $15 into this roll of film. So we will see if they're good. If they're good, there's a possibility that they're really good, because I was pretty proud of some of my pictures. Like, I thought they were pretty strong compositionally. I thought they were interesting. I thought they were kind of memorable. I made sure to take photos of like iconic things in my neighborhood at night, so you get a bit of a different angle, a different perspective. That's the word I'm looking for. You get a bit of a different perspective of them, so it'd be kind of interesting. It'd be novel. I have plenty of pictures of my neighborhood, but I don't have a whole bunch. Or I do have a whole bunch that are all the same. Just evening golden hour shots, because my neighborhood is a lake that points towards the sunset, and I take a lot of sunset pictures. But these are just pitch black. It was like 8 o'clock. Long exposures of that same view, just to see if it worked out. And the sky was really gorgeous. It was like an inky blue with some clouds interspersed in it. And the light pollution allowed you to see the clouds somewhat. And I hope it picked up on the film. It's 800 ISO film, which isn't super sensitive. Like, it's pretty sensitive, but it's not like pitch black night shot sensitive. So I took like a few 10 second exposures. I don't know if it'll turn out well. I definitely messed up one. The last one, it was gonna be the coolest picture ever, but I was standing in the road and a car came by and I had to move. This is the Beasley's house. They're awesome. We do stuff. In Larry's house as well. Whose truck is that? I don't know whose truck that is. Whose car is that? Who's over? This cul-de-sac has seen some stuff. One of my fondest memories is shooting each other with Roman candles during last July 4th. Was it July 4th? I think it was July 4th. I don't know, we shot each other with Roman candles, but might be back if we go to like Walmart or something. But if I'm not back, this has been a short episode of Weird Errands.
Thank you.